Now we will do exercise 13.2. In this exercise we are doing volume of combination of solids. We will do question number 1. A solid is in the shape of a cone standing on a hemisphere with both their radii being equal to 1 cm and the height of the cone is equal to its radius. Shape of a cone standing on a hemisphere. Exercise 13.2, question number 1. Cone standing on a hemisphere. So this is hemisphere and a cone standing on a hemisphere. So this is the shape of that solid. And here the radii equal to 1 cm and height of the cone equal to its radius. So radius 1 cm. And height of the cone, that is also 1 cm. 1 cm. And radii of both the figures, cone and hemisphere, both are same. Find the volume of the solid in terms of pi. That is our question. So volume of solid is equal to volume of cone plus volume of hemisphere. So that is the combination of this, this solid. This is the combination of hemisphere and cone. Therefore, the volume of solid is volume of cone plus volume of hemisphere. Volume of cone formula 1 by 3 pi r square h. And volume of hemisphere formula 2 by 3 pi r cube. And here radius and height same 1 cm. So 1 by 3 pi into 1 square into height 1 plus 2 by 3 pi into 1 cube. So we will get 1 by 3 pi plus 2 by 3 pi. So that is 3 by 3 pi, that is pi centimeter cube. So that is volume of the solid, that is pi centimeter cube. Then second question. Question number 2. Here, Rachel, an engineering student, was asked to make a model shaped like a cylinder with two cones attached at its two ends. Cylinder with two cones attached to its two ends. So here we have one cone and here another cone. So this is that model. The diameter of the model is 3 cm. Therefore, the radius 3 by 2 cm, diameter 3 cm and its height 12 cm, total height 12 cm, height of the model 12 cm. If each one has height 2 cm, the height of the conical part 2 cm, height of the conical part 2 cm. Find the volume of air contained in the model that Rachel made. So that is our question. We need to find the volume of the solid. So here, this is combination of solids. Here we have a cylinder and two cones attached to that cylinder. So the volume of the solid is equal to volume of the cylinder plus 2 into volume of the cone. Both the cones are identical. So here, radius of the cylinder 3 by 2. Radius of the cone 3 by 2. Height of the cone 2, but height of the cylinder we need to find. So total height 12 cm. So when we subtract 2 plus 2, that is 4. So when we subtract 2 from here and 2 from there, we will get a height of the cylinder. So height of the cylinder. Height of cylinder is equal to 12 minus 2 into 2. That is 12 minus 4, that is 8 cm. Then radius. Radius of equal to radius of cylinder and cone same 3 by 2 cm and height of cone is equal to 2 cm. Radius of cylinder equal to cone equal to 3 by 2 cm. Radius of cylinder equal to radius of cone equal to 3 by 2 cm. So now we can find the volume of air inside. So volume of air inside the solid is equal to volume of solid. So volume of solid is equal to volume of cylinder plus 2 into volume of cone. So volume of cylinder formula pi r square h plus 2 into volume of cone 1 by 3 pi r square h. That is so that is here height different, so we cannot combine them, but radius the same, so we can take pi r square, here 2 by 3, so pi r square we can take outside. Then the height of the conical part and height of the cylindrical part, both are different, so we cannot take the h common. So pi square is the height of the cylinder, or we will replace the values here. Pi square is the height of the cylinder, h. Pi square outside, hc plus 2 by 3 height of the cone, cylinder and cone. Now we can replace 22 by 7 into radius, that is 3 by 2 into 3 by 2. Then height of the cylinder, that is equal to 8 centimeter plus 2 by 3 common, 2 by 3 into height of the conical part, that is into 2. So when we simplify, we will get a volume of air inside the solid. So we will do question number 3. Third question. Third one. A gulab jamun contains sugar syrup up to about 30% of its volume. The 30% of the volume of the sweet, that is sugar syrup, find approximately how much syrup would be found in 45 gulab jamuns, each shaped like a cylinder with two hemispherical ends. Third one, the shape of that sweet, that is a cylinder, then hemispherical end. Cylinder with a hemispherical end. Cylinder with a hemispherical end. That is the shape of that sweet. And here cylindrical part. And here also cylindrical part. Then hemispherical end. Then each shaped like a cylinder with two hemispherical ends with length 5 cm. 5 cm total length. And diameter 2.8 cm. Therefore, the radius 1.4 cm. So, the height of the cylindrical part we need to find. Then we need to find find approximately how much syrup would be found in 25 sweets. That is our question. In 45 sweets. So, first we have to find volume of one sweet. So volume of one sweet is equal to volume of the cylinder plus 2 into volume of hemisphere. So when we join these two hemispheres together, we get one complete sphere. Therefore, the volume of one sweet is equal to volume of cylinder plus volume of sphere. So that will be the volume of one gulab jamun. Then into 45, that will be the total volume. Then 30% of that will be the quantity of sugar syrup in that 45 gulab jamuns. So that is our question. So first we will find height of the cylindrical part. Height of cylinder is equal to, so from both the end we need to, here 1.4, radius 1.4, and here also 1.4. So the height of the cylindrical part, that is 5 minus 1.4 minus 1.4. That means 5 minus 2.8. 5 minus 2.8. That is 2.2 centimeter. So that is height of the cylindrical part. So we will find volume of one gulab jamun is equal to volume of cylinder plus 2 into volume of hemisphere, or we can write volume of cylinder plus volume of hemisphere. So volume of cylinder formula pi r square h plus 2 into volume of hemisphere, that is 2 by 3 pi r cube. And here pi radius is same. So or we will write 22, we will replace 22 by 7 into radius. Radius 1.4, that is 14 upon 10 into 14 upon 10. 1.4 is 14 by 10 into height of the cylindrical part 2.2, that is 22 by 10 plus 2 into 4, 4 by 3 into 22 by 7 into radius, that is 14 by 10 into 14 by 10 into 14 by 10. So when we simplify, we will get a volume of 1 gulab jamun. Then we will write a volume of 45 gulab jamun, that is equal to 45 into volume of 1 gulab jamun. Then volume of sugar syrup. Volume of sugar syrup is equal to 30%. 30% of a volume of 45 gulab jamun. That is 30 divided by 100 into volume of 45 gulab jamun. So we can easily do that calculation. Height of the cylindrical part we got 2.2. Then volume of 1 gulab jamun, that is volume of cylindrical part plus 2 into volume of hemisphere. So when we simplify, we will get a volume of 1 gulab jamun. Then we have to find a volume of 45 gulab jamun, that is 45 into volume of 1 gulab jamun. So we will get the answer. Then volume of sugar syrup, that is 30% of the total volume, that is 30 upon 100 into total volume. So when you simplify, we will get a volume of sugar syrup. So now we will do fourth question. Fourth one. A pen stand made of wood in the shape of a cuboid with four conical depressions to hold the pens. So here we have a pen stand. Fourth question. Its shape is a cuboid and we have conical depressions, four conical depressions. Then four conical depressions to hold pens. The dimensions of the cuboid are 15 cm by 10 cm by 3.5 cm. So length 15 cm. Breadth 10 cm and height 3.5 cm. The radius of each depression is 0.5 cm and the depth 1.4 cm. So radius, so this is for cuboid. For cuboid. Then for cone, conical part, conical depression. Radius is given. Radius of each depression 0.5 cm. And the depth, that means height 1.4 cm. Then find the volume of wood in the entire stand. That is the solution. So here, this is a cuboid. And we have conical depressions. That means we removed wood in the shape of cones. So we have four conical depressions. So we removed wood. So therefore, we need to find a volume of wood in this pen stand. So volume of wood is volume of the cuboid minus 4 into volume of cone. Because these four cones are conical depressions. That means we removed. So the volume decreased. Therefore, volume of wood. Volume of wood is equal to volume of cuboid. Volume of cuboid minus 4 into volume of cone. Volume of cuboid, that is LBH, minus 4 into volume of cone, 1 by 3 pi r square h. So LBH, that is 15 into 10 into 3.5 minus 4 into 1 by 3 into 22 by 7 into radius square. So 0.5, that is 5 by 10 into 5 by 10 into height. 1.4, that is 14 by 10. And here 3.5, that is 35 by 10. So when we simplify, we will get a volume of wood, that is volume of cuboid minus 4 into volume of cone. So that is fourth question. Now we will do question number 5. So here in fifth question, a vessel is in the form of an inverted cone. Its height is 8 cm and the radius of its top is 5 cm. Question number 5. The shape of the vessel, that is an inverted cone. Inverted cone. Its height is 8 cm. Height 8 cm. And and its radius, that is 5 cm. Height 8 cm and the radius 5 cm. It is filled with water up to brim. Filled with water up to brim. When lead shots, each of which is a sphere of radius 0.5 cm, are dropped into the vessel, 1/4 of the water flows out. So here we are going to put some lead shots. The shape of the lead shot is a sphere, and when we put lead shot, it's filled up to the brim, so water overflows. So 1/4 of the water overflows when we put some lead shots. Find the number of lead shots dropped in the vessel. So that is our question. So here this vessel is filled with water up to the brim. So when we put lead shots, so when we put some lead shots, then water flows out. So suppose when we collect that water here, when we collect that water here, then it's given the volume of water flows out. That is given, that is 1/4 of the water flows out. 1/4 of the water flows out. Find the number of lead shots dropped in the vessel. So dimension of the cone is given, and the radius of the lead shot is given. So height of the cone, height of the cone, that is given, is equal to 8 cm. Then radius of the cone is equal to 5 cm. Then radius of lead shot, radius of lead shot, that is given 0.5 cm. 0.5 cm, that is equal to 5 by 10 cm. 0.5 cm. Then when we put some lead shots, water flows out. Then we have 1/4 of the water flows out. We need to find the number of lead shots. Let the number of lead shots, number of lead shots, let the number of lead shots be n. So suppose we are dropping n lead shots, then water flows out and 1/4 of the water flows out. So the volume of water flows out is equal to sum of the volumes of lead shots. So when we put lead shots, the volume of water flows out and sum of the volumes of the lead shots, same. So in physics you might have learned. So we can write a volume, sum of the volumes of lead shots is equal to sum of the volumes of lead shots is equal to volume of water flows out. So volume of, sum of the volumes of lead shot. So here we have n lead shots, therefore sum of the volumes of lead shot is equal to n into volume of one lead shot. Volume of one lead shot. that is sum of the volumes of less shores, equal to volume of water flows out, that is 1 by 4 into volume of cone. So 1/4 of the volume of water flows out. Then n into volume of one less shore. Shape is a sphere, so 4 by 3 pi r cube is equal to 1 by 4 into volume of cone, that is 1 by 3 pi r square h. And here radius, both the radius same, different. So pi can be cancelled. And 3 also we will cancel, but radius we cannot cancel. This is radius of the less shore and this is radius of the vessel. So we will replace n into, here 4 is there, 4 into r cube. Radius of the less shore, that is 5 by 10 into 5 by 10 into 5 by 10 equal to, and here 1 by 4 into r square, radius 5 into 5 into height of 8. Therefore n is equal to, that is number of less shores, equal to 1 by 4 into 5 into 5 into 8 into, we can take it from left to right, 4 becomes 1 by 4, then 5 by 10 becomes 10 by 5 into 10 by 5. So now we can simplify. 5, 5 cancelled, again cancelled. Then 8 and 4 cancelled, here 2. Then 2 and 4 cancelled, 2. Then 10 and 2 cancelled, so here 5. Then this 5 and this 5 cancelled. So 10 into 10, so that is 100. So the number of less shores dropped in the vessel, that is 100. So that is question number 5. Then 6th question. And here, a solid iron pole consists of a cylinder of height 220 cm and its base diameter 24 cm. 6th one. A cylinder of height 220 cm and base radius. And base radius, base diameter 24 cm, so base radius 12 cm. Which is surmounted by another cylinder of height 60 cm. Surmounted by another cylinder of height 60 cm. So here height 60 cm. And radius 8 cm. So here radius 8 cm. Find the mass of the pole. Given that 1 cm cube of iron has approximately 8 gram mass. So here pi is equal to 3.14. So we need to find the mass of the iron. Given that, find the mass of the pole. So we will find the volume of the pole. Volume of the pole is equal to volume of bigger cylinder plus volume of smaller cylinder. Volume of bigger cylinder plus volume of smaller cylinder. So we have two cylinders, bigger and smaller. So volume of pole, iron pole, that is volume of bigger cylinder plus volume of smaller cylinder. So volume of bigger cylinder, that is pi capital R square H plus volume of smaller cylinder, pi small r square h. And here we can take capital R, that is volume of bigger cylinder. For bigger cylinder, R is equal to 12 cm and height is equal to 220 cm. And for smaller cylinder, radius is equal to 8 cm and height is equal to 60 cm. So for smaller cylinder, radius 8 cm and height is 60 cm. So when we replace, we will get pi we have to replace by 22 by 7. So we can take pi outside. Then r square h plus r square small h. So 3.14 into r square, 12 into height 220 plus 8 into height 60. So when we simplify, we will get a volume of ball. Now we have to find the mass of the ball. Mass of the ball. Mass is equal to volume is equal to so we need to find the density is equal to mass by volume. Density is mass by volume, therefore mass is equal to volume into density. Volume into density, that is given 1 centimeter cube of iron has approximately 8 gram. So volume into 8 gram. So when we simplify, we will get a the mass of the ball. So that is volume into 8 gram. Then seventh question. Question number 7. Here, a solid consisting of a right circular cone of height 120 cm and radius 60 cm standing on a hemisphere of radius 6 cm, sorry, of radius 60 cm is placed upright in a right circular cylinder full of water such that it touches the bottom. Find the volume of water left inside the cylinder if the radius of the cylinder is 60 cm and its height is 180 cm. So here question number 7, and here we have one solid. So the shape of the solid is a cone on a hemisphere. So this is the shape of that solid. A cone on a hemisphere. And here radius, height, everything given. A solid consists of right circular cone of height 120 cm. Height 120 cm. And radius 60 cm. Standing on a hemisphere of radius 60 cm, radius of cone and radius of hemisphere same. Placed upright in a right circular cylinder full of water such that it touches the bottom. Find the volume of water left in the cylinder if the radius of the cylinder 60 cm and its height 120 cm. So this solid, we will keep this solid in a cylinder. We will keep the solid in the cylinder and the height of the cylinder is 180 cm. 180 cm, and radius given and it touches the base. Then that cylinder filled with water. That cylinder filled with water up to the brim. And when we place that solid inside the cylinder filled with water up to the brim, then water flows out. Then we need to find, our question is, find the volume of water left in the cylinder if the radius of the cylinder is 60 cm. Radius of the cylinder 60 cm and height 180 cm. So here we place the, we put this solid in that cylinder. We need to find the volume of water left. Volume of water left, that is equal to volume of cylinder minus volume of solid. Volume of water left is equal to volume of cylinder, volume of cylinder minus volume of solid. So volume of cylinder, that is volume of cylinder, volume of cylinder, then minus in bracket volume of solid, that is volume of solid is volume of cone plus volume of hemisphere. Then volume of cylinder formula pi r square h minus volume of cone 1 by 3 pi r square h plus volume of hemisphere 2 by 3 pi r cube. Now we have to replace everything. The value of pi, that is 22 by 7, into radius of cylinder, that is 60 into 60, height of the cylinder 180 minus, then 1 by 3 into 22 by 7 into radius of cone, that is 60 into height of the cone, that is 120, then plus in bracket 2 by 3 into 22 by 7 into radius of the hemisphere, that is again 60 into 60 into 60. So when we simplify, we can take 22 by 7 outside, then 60 into 60 we can take outside, 22 by 7 into 60 into 60 we can take outside, then 180 minus 1 by 3 into 120 we will cancel, then when we simplify we will get the answer. We have to take it outside, then it will be very easy. So that will be volume of water left inside the cylinder. Then last one, question number 8. Eighth question. A spherical glass vessel has cylindrical neck 8 cm long and 2 cm in diameter. The diameter of the spherical part is 8.5 cm. So here we have a vessel, a spherical vessel with a cylindrical neck, and here we have a cylindrical neck. A spherical vessel with a cylindrical neck, and its height is given 8 cm, and its 2 cm diameter, therefore radius is equal to 1 cm. 2 cm diameter, radius 1 cm. The diameter of the spherical part is 8.5 cm, therefore the radius is 8.5 divided by 2. By measuring the amount of water it holds, a child finds its volume to be 345 cm³. Check whether she is correct, taking the above as the inside measurement. So pi is 3.14. So we have to find the volume. So when we find the volume, volume of vessel is equal to volume of sphere plus volume of cylinder. So that is the volume of vessel, volume of sphere plus volume of cylinder. And here this is actually spherical shape, so if it is a proper cylinder, and if it is a proper sphere and when we attach a cylinder, then cylinder here it is straight, so here we have one some space that is common to both sphere and cylinder. So this part. So when we attach one cylinder here, so here volume of the cylinder, that means this volume is included in volume of the sphere, and the same volume included in volume of the cylinder, but we are avoiding that part, we don't consider that part actually. So the volume of the sphere we can easily find 4 by 3 pi r cube plus volume of cylinder pi r square h, 4 by 3 pi r cube plus pi r square h, that is 4 by 3 into 3.14, pi we will take outside. Then when we simplify, 3. Pi we can take outside. Pi into 4 by 3 r cube plus r square h. That is 3.14. Then 4 by 3 into r cube. Radius of the cylinder. That is 85 upon 20 into 85 upon 20 into 85 upon 20 plus r square. 1 square, that is 1 into height 8. So when we simplify, we will get a volume of the vessel. But in that question, volume of the vessel. So here, volume of the sphere means this part is included in sphere, and plus volume of the cylinder, that part again included. So that volume should be subtracted from here, then only you will get a actual volume. But in this case, that volume is negligible, so we don't consider. So volume of the vessel, we are here assuming volume of sphere plus volume of cylinder. So when you simplify, we will get this answer we will compare with one answer is given. We will compare with that answer, then we can decide whether it is correct or not.